35-year-old female with multiple sclerosis. She tripped on a loose rug this morning while trying to go to the bathroom. Now she complains of left hip pain.
She's 35?
Yes, and she has fatigue, weakness, and a UTI.
Page Dr. Lisa B. right away.
Hi, my name is Lisa. I'll be the nurse helping you in your care today. Please get your first and last name.
Billy Eilish.
Okay, and your date of birth?
August 24th, 1987.
Okay, so today we're going to do a focus assessment for you. You were complaining that you have left hip pain, right?
Yes.
Okay, so before I begin on that, I do
have... Is it going to hurt?
It's not going to hurt at all. It'll be very quick and easy, okay?
Okay.
So first, I do need to ask you a few questions that may sound unusual, but it helps me evaluate you fully, okay? Okay, do you know where you're at?
In the hospital.
Okay, do you know the reason why you're here?
Because I fell.
Okay, and do you know what year it is?
2022.
Okay, correct. So I'm going to do an eye assessment for you, okay?
Okay.
Please close your eyes. Open. Close your eyes again. Open. Okay. You focus on this pen and the wall behind me and back at the pen. Okay, thank you. Do you have any like vision issues right now at all?
No.
Okay. For now, I'm gonna take a look at your left hip.
Okay.
Okay, I'm just gonna pull this up real quick. Okay, there's no skin breakdown. There's no lesions that I observe. Okay, I'm going to raise up the bed and do your focus assessment, okay?
Okay.
Okay, you're complaining about experiencing pain. Can you rate your pain 0 from being no pain and 10 from being the worst pain you ever had?
10.
Okay, so when did it start?
I fell last night trying to go to the bathroom.
Okay, and where is your pain right now?
My left hip.
Okay, and how long has this been lasting?
Ever since I fell.
Okay. Has there been anything that made it feel worse?
Just trying to walk.
Okay, has there been anything that made it feel better?
No, I haven't done anything for it.
And have you had any other treatments that relieve your pain?
No.
So I need you to raise your knee to your chest for me and back down if you're able to. Are you able to do that?
As far as it goes.
Okay, that's okay. You can put it back down. So it seems like your range of motion is very limited. Can you lift your feet to my hand? Okay, back down. Okay, your strength is normal. I'm going to remove your socks, okay? Check your cap refill. See if your perfusion is okay. Okay, everything looks normal. And check your pulse. Okay, plus 2 normal. That's a good sign. And also, do you have any trouble walking at all? Do you need any assistance?
Yeah, I think so.
And what do you use for help?
Nothing normally.
Okay. Is there any other potential tripping hazards at home?
Well, the damn kids leave their toys everywhere.
Yeah, we actually just had to downsize because I lost my job. So we were in a 5-bedroom home, now we're in a 2-bedroom home. So the space we have not adapted to. I mean, my wife has her stuff laying everywhere. We got power cords, the hair straighteners hanging out. You know, the cat likes to run in front of us. And the dang kids. The kids throw their Legos everywhere.
This news frightened Nurse Lisa, and she fearfully pictured all of the potential tripping hazards Mrs. Eyelash might have.
To speak with your doctor, okay? And if you do have any questions or concerns at all, I'll put this call light right next to you. Just press the red button and then you'll be in to help me out, okay?
Okay. Do you think you could get me some water?
Yes, of course. I'll be back with some water for you.
Do you guys have pudding too?
Pudding?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, I would have to check with your dietitian first, okay? If that can, you can tolerate that.
Okay.
Hi doctor, we have a 35-year-old female patient. Her name is Billy Eilish. So she has a history of multiple sclerosis and she was diagnosed 5 years ago. And she's experienced increased fatigue and weakness over the past month on her left lower leg. And today she tripped on a loose rug. Her previous medical history is also depression, total hysterectomy 4 years ago, and frequent urinary tract infections over the past 2 years. The current medications that she's taking is Ovenex, Zoloft, and multivitamins. What I see that's abnormal in her labs is traces of white blood cells in her urine analysis.
Okay, thank you. I'm gonna go look at her x-rays and I'll go talk to her.
Dr. Lisa B. looked at the hip x-rays and concluded there was not a hip fracture.
Hi, doctor.
Hi, Mrs. Eyelash. I'm happy to let you know that your hip isn't broken.
Oh, that's great news.
So we'll get your pain under control and then you can go home.
Whoa, 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 Billy. We're not doing this again. We need to figure out how we can improve our situation.
Honey, I'm going to miss American Idol.
I don't care. You're not falling again.
Well, it is really important that we make sure that you don't have another fall in your house again. So I'm going to have a home healthcare nurse come to your home to do an assessment for risk and give you some suggestions on how you can prevent a further fall. I'm also going to order PT to come and work with you to help maintain your mobility and give you some exercises you can do at home to strengthen your muscles. I want to remind you that having MS impairs your sensory function, and so you're going to have to be careful with common things like testing your bath water to make sure it's not too hot before you step into it. Be really careful using ice packs or heat packs, as you might not be able to sense the temperature, and to check your skin for little cuts or pressure ulcers to make sure that those don't get out of control. Do you have any questions?
No.
Okay, so I'm going to send PT in here, and she'll begin working with you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Diana. I'm your physical therapist, and I'm here to show you how to use this cane so you can be more stable when you walk.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to put the bed up here. And then I'm going to have you slowly lift your body up for me. And then I'm going to have you hang your feet off the edge of the bed. Dizzy at all, lightheaded?
No.
Here Diana is assessing that Mrs. Eyelash is not dizzy. She's holding the cane on her strong side. She's applying all of her weight on her good leg and keeping that weak leg forward. Here Diana is monitoring proper cane usage. Mrs. Eyelash steps forward with the cane and the weak leg first, followed by the good leg.
I'm doing it.
Yes, you are, honey.
Oh.
Mrs. Eyelash is discharged and she promises she will go to physical therapy 3 times a week as well as cleaning up some of the clutter around the house.
What's my first and last name?
We actually just moved to a smaller home. I'm sorry.
You're too into character design right now.
Okay.
Does it look funny with the...
It looks like you don't have a forehead.
What do you guys do now?
The pain is like...
It's on the left hip.
Left hip?
Is it left hip?
How do I get up again?
Crap. That having MS puts you at increased risk for